Welcome, David.
Is this heaven?
Mighty presumptuous of you, don't you think?
Doesn't look like hell to me.
Well, you're right about that, but this isn't heaven either.
I get it. I'm on trial for what I did, right? And you're here to determine where I go beyond this point.
I know I had a smart one. Come.
So what do I call you?
Lisa's fine. Sit. So, where do we begin?
You tell me.
First, tell me where you think you belong.
At this point, I have no clue.
No clue? Why do you think that is?
I'm just a little hazy over the situation, I guess.
So you think what you did was wrong?
In a way, I do, and I don't.
I guess I'm waiting for you to tell me if I'm wrong.
And what about Stacy? Do you think she deserved what happened to her? Let's skip that question for now. Why do you think she visited you that morning?
Hey, baby.
Hi.
How was your sleep?
I could use a bit more.
No time for that now. You have a busy day ahead of you.
We can start a little business of our own right now.
Wait.
Why?
Because you have to atone.
Atone for what?
For what you've done to me.
What did I do to you? Stacy. What did I do to you? Stacy. Stacy.
Look at me, David. Look at what you've done to me.
So how did that dream affect you?
It freaked me out.
Is that why you decided to tell your friend Cal?
I had to tell someone.
Yo, that's fucked up. Dang. Wait a second, you saying there's something significant about the dream?
I do. It felt different.
Like I was pulled to a different plane of existence.
Yo, you're looking way too deep into this shit, man.
Why would you say that?
Alright, look. Don't take it the wrong way and all. But it's been about 6 months since Stacy was killed, and they haven't solved the case yet. Do you think your dream has something to do with that frustration, or it could be guilt?
What would I be guilty of?
I don't know, not being able to do anything about it. You probably thought it was your fault why she was raped and killed.
Why are you trying to analyze me right now?
You've been obsessing over this shit for a long ass time now. It's almost as if you're feeling to investigate it yourself.
I'm not gonna go investigating, come on.
I mean, yo, that must have been some sick ass dream you had. You better start loosening the fuck up before this shit breaks you.
So you expect me to just forget it and let her death go?
I'm not even saying that. Just don't let it consume you, that's all.
Well, if you knew how I felt about her, you wouldn't be saying all this shit to me right now.
I already know how you feel about her, and your judgment's been fucked up lately. As a matter of fact, it's been fucked up ever since you met Stacy, and you're starting to piss me off.
What do you mean by that?
If you knew what the fuck I knew, you would've dead this shit a long ass time ago. I mean, you would've still felt bad and all, but you still would've deaded it.
Well, what do you know? Tell me, Cal. What the fuck is it that you know?
Hold on. Somebody's calling me. Hello? Oh, what's up? Oh, you outside? All right, I'm coming to get you.
You ain't gonna tell me?
Yo, just give me a second. James is outside, all right?
Did you have any idea what he could have been talking about?
At the time, I didn't. But knowing what I know now, I think deep down, I knew.
Do you ever think about the first time you met her?
That girl's been grilling you, yo.
Which one?
The one in the middle.
Yeah, well, she's been really hard, son. Right up.
Damn, she fine as fuck, too.
Yo, if you go get that in your team, you're gonna be out here, too.
Damn, but I hate moving around girls when they got people around them.
Yo, stop being a bitch, yo. Just go hide, yo. She looks like she's feeling you.
I don't.
Hey, what's up?
Wow, no spa pickup line?
Nope, just what's up. Is it working for you?
Mm-hmm. I don't know yet, but we're gonna have to see how it goes. Can I get you something while I'm at it?
Hey, that's my line.
Mistake, you claim my lounge now?
Nah, but I have a drink.
I can't believe he said that.
That was one time I wish I was a magician. I could just disappear.
Well, at least you can laugh about it now.
Not sure.
It's time for the old what do you do for a living question.
Question. Well, I'm a lab technician for a pharmaceutical company.
Wow, a science geek.
Come on, I'm not a science geek.
Sure you are.
So what do you do?
I'm a telemarketer.
Ha! One of the most annoying people in the world. And you're one of them.
Hey, I resent that.
And I just love the science geek quip.
Well, I apologize. And I have you know I make a lot of money doing this.
All this stuff of work reminds me I have to get up early in the morning. So I can get your number and I'll give you a call and we can hang out sometime.
I'll do you one better. I'll leave with you. I have to get up early in the morning too. Let me just say that to a couple people first.
I take it that went well?
Pretty well, actually. I'm about to be out and she's coming with me.
Where, to your crib?
I don't know yet, but I ain't gonna force that shit.
Who shit me even be?
Shut up.
Why is that dude looking at us?
Actually, I saw him looking at David when he was talking to that chick.
Yo, we got a problem? Dorso!
Yo, I gotta go get my jacket.
I think it's in that room over there.
Of course she didn't come to my house that night. I got her number and we hung out the next day. For some strange reason, everything started to come back to me after I had that dream about her.
Which I presume started the chain of events that led you here.
Yo, you alright in there?
Yeah, man. I'm cool. I just saw a big ass roach.
Alright, man. Me and James in the room.
Alright.
Yo, I'm serious, James. You don't fucking tell him I will.
You think you got or something? You just meddling in shit that don't concern you.
First off, it does concern me because David's my friend and what you and Stacy did was fucked up.
What the fuck did you and Stacy do?
Look, David.
Don't fucking look David me, motherfucker. What did you and Stacy do?
Stop being a pussy, James. Just tell him.
Shut the fuck up, Cal.
Shut up, Cal. Let me speak. Let me hear it.
Look, me and Stacy, we had sex.
Motherfucker!
Was killing your friend the answer?
If he could do that to me, he was never my friend.
You fucking piece of shit. I can't believe you did this to me. I should fucking slit your throat.
David, chill, yo. You don't even want to do this right now. Besides, it's not like he forced himself on her.
I know he isn't the one who raped and killed her.
What? You should direct that question to yourself, man.
What do you mean by that?
If it wasn't for me, your ass would be in jail right now.
Why would I be in jail?
David, chill. Just drop the fucking listen. I think you want to hear this, man.
Do you even remember where you were the night she got killed?
It's like I told you guys, the cops and everybody else. I must have blacked out that day.
And with a statement like that, you never wondered why you were never a suspect?
They had no reason to suspect me.
Really? Well, since you don't remember, let me enlighten you. I went to Stacy's apartment that night to see her. That's when I saw you leaving her apartment. I decided to check on her, and what I saw will stay with me forever. I called out to Stacy, and I didn't hear nothing. I decided to check her room, and that's when I saw it. I saw her lifeless body lying on a bed. That's when I left the apartment. The next day, after the cops discovered the body, they came to my place to question me, as I'm sure they did you guys. I told them I was at your crib and drinking, and it was the first time you got drunk. They couldn't prove we were elsewhere, so I guess we were off the list of suspects.
I didn't kill her. I couldn't have.
Well, you was the last one to leave the apartment before James discovered the body. And you didn't mention to anybody about seeing her dead.
That could mean that James killed her.
Why would I kill your girl?
Why would you fuck my girl?
And you knew all about this shit and you didn't say nothing to me? You see me going through all of this and you didn't say shit?
David, look.
Don't say shit to me. I'm leaving before I do some crazy shit.
David.
So what stopped you from killing him?
I guess it wasn't in me to kill him.
And yet you're still here.
I guess killing was partly in me.
Fucking two-timing bitch.
Something's not right. That can't be how it happened. And I couldn't have killed her.
Yo, who the fuck?
Wake up, David. David, wake up. David.
Stacy?
You just stood there and watched him kill me. I didn't deserve this. I didn't deserve to die. And I certainly didn't deserve you watching me do it. Now it's time to feel my pain.
You was in a position that most men wish they could be. It was your job to look over. It was your job to make sure she's straight. But you couldn't even do that. Man, if I was a man, I would have watched her better. If I was a man, I would have watched her constantly.
So what now?
Do you see how powerful the mind is, David? For you to mentally block who this girl really was shows what the mind can achieve. But I'm afraid human emotions can't keep up with the power of the mind. Therefore, the unraveling of your memory caused you to snap and kill that man. Your mind especially is powerful, David. That's why we were able to give you this gift.
What gift?
You've been given the second chance to do the right thing, David. You lived an entire half a year in your mind. All the emotional and physical aspect of that entire 6 months has been in your mind.
My mind?
Yes, David. And with this gift, all we want you to do is take care of that mind of yours. In time, we will need its power.
Cleaned up. I'm gonna call the cops. Then we have some stuff to talk about.
I just want to say thank you. I appreciate what you guys did for me.
It's been my pleasure, David.
Game of turning white to black.